There were three people who are responsible for my obsessive compulsiveness when it comes to movies and particularly the buildings they are run in. Two of those people are called Mom and Dad, who discovered that the Egyptian had Saturday morning kids shows. Great way to get rid of me. The third person is Ted Kirkmeyer, who was the manager of the theater at the time. Ted Kirkmeyer was eventually promoted, and in comes Bill Suter. Bill Suter recognized me because I was in there quite often. He says, "I maybe have a job for you." Well, I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. I got tired of working weekends, and so a position opened up at Weber State in printing services, and I ended up going up there. And then, in fact, I only had two full-time jobs my whole life. One lasted 8 months at the Egyptian, and the next one lasted 40 years at Weber State University. I loved the theater so much that I went back as a part-time doorman. I got to know all the projectionists, and one of them urged me to become a union projectionist. It was a fascinating job. I particularly liked it working at the Egyptian. I loved it when you had to do the changeovers. Each reel would last about 18 minutes. If you did the changeovers from the end of one reel to the other on the second projector, nobody would notice. And that was great pride for projectionists. Well, I have been a member of a national group called the Theater Historical Society of America since 1973. And so I've seen in every big city, in a lot of little cities, what was happening to these theaters. The downtown areas were deteriorating. The competition from malls were closing up these magnificent theaters that had played such an important role in the entertainment of these communities. The Egyptian closed, I think, the last week of December of 1984. So I knew something had to be done. I wrote a letter to the editor to have a planning meeting to see if we could get some plan in place to make an effort to save and get the theater restored. Out of that meeting came the Egyptian Theater Foundation. It was a remarkable thing to pull off. It took 12 years from the day that theater closed till the day it reopened. Many of those years, dark, gloomy, very sad days, because we came so close to losing that theater so many times. And it took a miracle. And we have this miraculous building, and what a remarkable group of people who came together and made it work. I was lucky to have great parents and a great childhood. And now that I look back over my life, the thing that's brought me the most joy is volunteering. I think you can never get enough of that. There's so much that needs to be done or could be done. And it's funny how things pull together, because the person that's volunteering reaps as much joy and satisfaction as the person that you're helping. So that's one thing I would leave, urge you to volunteer and go to the Egyptian once in a while.